Read the words. A well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state. Sure, you need an organized military force to defend your country, but the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. This is the people, in contrast with the militia. It doesn't say the right of the militia to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. It says the right of the people. Now, why the word people? Because the people who wrote this had just fought a war for 2 years against a tyrannical state militia. They knew the time might come when they'd have to do that again. So they made the possession of weapons a right that the militia could never take away.
You can't get rid of guns. You know, that's, you know, so what are the alternatives? You know,
what do we do?
Guns don't go away. It's a Second Amendment right, obviously. Taking people's right to protect themselves from bad people that would do that is not something you can do.
No, I think that you can't start to pick apart any of anything out of the Bill of Rights without thinking that it's all going to become undone. If you take one out or change one law, then why wouldn't they take all your rights away from you?
You carry guns
not
routinely at home? I mean, you have a gun at home?
Yeah, it's legal in the United States. It's part of our Constitution. You know, the right to bear arms is because that's the last form of defense against tyranny. Not to hunt, but hunt.
And do you see any link between that and these sorts of incidents?
No. Nah, not really. You know what I'm saying? If somebody wants to kill people, you know, they don't need a gun to do it.
Makes it easier though, doesn't it?
Not really. You can use, you can strap explosives on your body. They do that all the time.
He just equated gun owners to Nazis.
Right? And chihuahuas.
I'm sorry, if you don't like that, write it down. We've given you
guns. You shouldn't like that.
Are you defending that?
That's offensive.
Are you defending him with
I'm
guns?
I am not
all fighting citizens,
I'm
Nazis?
Asking you.
Doesn't matter why they include it. The question is, do we want it? Do we need it now? And is it relevant to
today? Sir, freedom of religion is a man.
While you're standing up, I'm sat here in heaven here right now, and I would like to agree with the professor. Everyone standing in this room right now, especially the veterans in this room right now, know that we are all Americans. The problem with this country right now is it's us. We need to stop this crap. Now, the thing I would like you to answer, sir, and I did go to war for this country.
Yeah!
My name is Bill Stevens. I live in Newtown. My fifth grade daughter was in lockdown on December 14, 2012. Unfortunately, her classmate's little sister was murdered in Sandy Hook that day when lockdown and 911 weren't enough to protect her from an evil person. not protect her from an assault rifle or some type of inanimate object, but from an evil person. Quite different from the elaborate security you all enjoy here at the Capitol. It was fun getting frisks on the way in. Section 15 reads very clearly, we all know what the Second Amendment says, but Section 15 in the state constitution says very clearly every citizen has a right to bear arms in defense of himself and the state. There's no registration, there's no permitting, there's no background checks. It's quite clear. These rights are inalienable and endowed by our creator, not you politicians, to all citizens regardless of gender, race, or creed. In order to limit the rights of individuals, there is something called due process, and legislation is not due process. You want to take my rights away? Let's go to court. My guns are not dangerous. They are at home, locked up, collecting dust and cat hair. But criminals and tyrants especially, beware. Lockdown is not an option at the Stevens residence. And 911 will be dialed after the security of my home has been established. Charlton Heston made the phrase, from my cold dead hands, famous. And I will tell you here today, you will take my ability to protect my Victoria from my cold dead hands.
As I mentioned, I'm not really mad at the guy that did this. And I'm certainly not mad at the guns that did this. They didn't walk in there by themselves and pull their own triggers. The guy that did it was a lunatic. That's like being mad at a rabid dog. I'm mad at my legislators for legislating me out of the right to protect myself and my family. I would much rather be sitting in jail with a felony offense on my head and have my parents alive. As far as these so-called assault weapons, you say that they don't have any defense use. You tell that to the guy that I saw on a videotape of the LA riot, standing up on his rooftop, protecting his property and his life from an entire mob with one of these so-called assault weapons. Tell me that he didn't have a legitimate self-defense use. Just one final statement. I've been sitting here getting more and more fed up with all of this talk about these pieces of machinery having no legitimate sporting purpose, no legitimate hunting purpose. People, that is not the point of the Second Amendment. The Second Amendment is not about duck hunting. And I know I'm not going to make very many friends saying this, but it's about our rights, all of our rights, to be able to protect ourselves from all of you guys up there.
No, not at all.
It is.
Because I was in the Philippines physically the day Ferdinand Marcos declared martial law and made himself a dictator. And the first thing that dictator did, he gave the people of the Philippines 2 weeks to turn in all their guns or it was the death penalty. Now, why would a dictator do that? Why would he make his number one priority when he took over as dictator to disarm the public? The Second Amendment is there, so, and it was put in there not for hunting and fishing, like they like to say, because back when they did it, if you didn't hunt or fish, you didn't eat. It was put in there so the citizens would have the ability, if their government became oppressive, they could defend themselves against oppressive government. And I think that overrules all the gun deaths, because let's remember something. A gun is simply a tool. I have a gun safe at home, and I've never come home and heard those guns going off on their own. People kill people. Police can't stop crimes. Police show up after they're over. Remember that. How many people here think I make crackpot points?
Yeah.
One. How many think I make sensible points? You're in a minority, my good friend. You're the minority.
Do you care about murders, or do you only care about murders with guns?
I care about all deaths.
I don't think you do. I think you care about guns. I think you're obsessed with guns.
No, I'm obsessed.
99.99% of the gun owners of America are wonderful people that you are hanging around with here today. Perfectly safe, perfectly harmless, wonderful, loving, giving, generous, caring people. Would you leave us the hell alone?
What is your response to what the president is trying to do? Which of his proposals do you agree with?
Well, I think I can frame it best by identifying the scammer in chief who claims that just to save one life would be worth this.
Isn't it worth it? Well,
he had a chance to save four American lives in Benghazi and he refused to do so. Now he's sending F-16s to Egypt. So how can you believe this guy? This guy is on record. This president of ours has been voted in by that clueless majority who is so out of touch, they still call magazine clips. They still call personal defense weapons assault weapons.
Mega banks that control the planet and brag that they've taken over, in Bloomberg, AP, Reuters, you name it, brag that they're going to get our guns as well. They've taken everybody's guns but the Swiss and the American people. And when they get our guns, they can have their world tyranny. While the government buys 1.6 billion bullets, armored vehicles, tanks, helicopters, predator drones, armed, now in U.S. skies, being used to arrest people in North Dakota, the Second Amendment isn't there for duck hunting. It's there to protect us from tyrannical government and street thugs. Take the women in India. Your piece earlier on CNN I was watching during Anderson Cooper's show didn't tell you that the women of India have signed giant petitions to get firearms because the police can't and won't protect them. The answer wait a minute. I have FBI crime statistics that come out a year late, 2011. 20%+ crime drop in the last 9 years. Real violent crime because more guns means less crime. Britain took the guns 15, 16 years ago. Tripling of your overall violent crime. True, we have a higher gun violence level, but overall mugging, stabbings, deaths. Those men raped that woman in India to death with an iron rod 4 feet long. You can't ban the iron rods. The guns, the iron rods, Pierce, didn't do it. The tyrants did it. Hitler took the guns. Stalin took the guns. Mao took the guns. Fidel Castro took the guns. Hugo Chavez took the guns. And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. Doesn't matter how many lemmings you get out there on the street begging for them to have their guns taken. We will not relinquish them. Do you understand?
It is the concentration of power among the few, such as what we see in a dictatorship, that leads to corruption and exploitation of the people. When the government wants to force people to do what it wants, it uses guns. This force will only become more aggressive, more tyrannical, and more dangerous if the imbalance of power is swayed in the government's favor through disarmament of the citizens. The crux of the anti-gun movement, you see, is not to disarm the government. It is to selectively disarm private citizens only, therefore granting what is called a monopoly of violence to the government itself. This is openly revealed as the true purpose of gun restrictions and disarmament legislation, to monopolize the use of force into the hands of the government itself, to hold the people of the world in a perpetual state of surrender to those who control the guns, the governments. And when that happens, history has shown that a monopoly of force often ends in mass murder. In just the last century, armed governments possessing a monopoly on gun control have directly killed over a quarter of a billion people on our planet. R.J. Rummel at the University of Hawaii has extensively studied what's called democide, a term describing death by government.
To put democide into perspective, it would take 10 sports stadiums jam-packed with 100,000 people apiece to represent 1 million souls. China, from 1949 to 1987, the Communist Party killed 76+ million people, and they even admit it. They're proud of it. The USSR, from 1917 to 1987, killed over 61 million people. Combined Western colonialism killed over 50 million people. Germany, under Hitler, from 1933 to 1945, killed more than 20 million people total, including their own population. Japan, during its imperial orgy, from 1936 to 1945, killed 5+ million people. Before Mao even got into power, from 1923 to 1948, they killed right around 3.5 million. And good old Pol Pot in Cambodia, funded by the U.S. government and Zbigniew Brzezinski from 1975 to 1979, killed around 30% of his population, 2 million. Turkey during their genocide of the Armenians, 1.8 million. Vietnam, 1.67 million. Poland, 1.585 million. Pakistan, 1.5 plus million. Yugoslavia under Tito, 1,072,000. And the mega murder just continues. North Korea, 1.663 million. Mexico, 1,417,000. Russia, before the communists even got in, killed over 1 million. And it just goes on and on and on. For a whopping conservative total of 262 million. Governments winning the war against humanity. And let me just be clear. That's governments killing unarmed civilians. That doesn't even count military casualties. If you add those in, it's well over 350 million. So democide, or death by government, is the number one threat because it's already been carried out many, many times. And governments all over the world are engaging in mass murder right now. And our own government, under the National Defense Authorization Act, is openly stating that they will kill U.S. citizens, secretly arrest U.S. citizens, and have us disappear into secret prisons and black holes. So the gauntlet has been thrown down in front of us.